The most dangerous volcanoes on the planet include Mount Vesuvius in Italy, Mount Rainier in the United States, and Nyiragongo in the Democratic Republic of Congo. So, why is a little-known volcano within Papua New Guinea also considered to be one of the most dangerous volcanoes? The volcano I'm referring to is known as Ulawun, which is one of the 16 designated decade volcanoes. Decade volcanoes represent the most destructive volcanoes on the planet as decided by panels of scientists. The main reason for its designation is the risk of catastrophic summit collapse, much like seen during the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, only on a greater scale. In my opinion, it is quite likely that this volcano will partially or completely collapse in the next 10,000 years, putting millions of people at risk. The Ulawun volcano is located in eastern Papua New Guinea, where it is located on the island of New Britain. As we zoom in from satellite, the prominent red top of this volcano becomes ever so clear. The reason it is red relates to its overall composition. This red material consists of both Strombolian-style eruptive products known as scoria and small amounts of red-colored ash. The most prominent feature on this volcano is a 200-meter or 656-foot-tall scar visible on its southern flank. This scar does not represent a caldera collapse, but rather an ancient summit collapse. Although the age of the summit collapse is unknown, it likely occurred within the last 20,000 years. This collapse caused a large section of the volcano, perhaps the entirety of the existing edifice, to slide to the north. This debris flow covered a vast area and even reached the ocean. The reason why we are afraid of a similar disaster occurring again relates to Ulawun's height. It stands at 2,334 meters or 7,657 feet tall. On its own, this might not seem significant, so here is the relevant context. In eastern New Britain, there are large calderas almost everywhere. This includes Rabol, Lolabu, Hargi, and Karai. Caldera formation seems to represent a natural portion of a volcano's lifespan and the overall volcanic chain. Scientists have noted that these caldera collapses seem to occur right after a volcano reaches approximately 1,900 meters in height. Thus, Ulawun is largely overdue for either a massive summit collapse or a caldera-forming eruption. These adjacent caldera-forming eruptions have been quite large, on occasion ejecting more than 50 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock. If this was to occur, every citizen within a 30-kilometer radius totaling 20,000 people would be put at risk. Another less prominent feature of Ulawun is a grouping of six satellite cinder cones. These cinder cones form via Strombolian-style eruptions and represent a northwest-trending series of fissures which feed the volcano's underlying magma chamber. Thus, areas up to 13 kilometers from Ulawun's summit have been the site of young lava flows. Some of these flows originate through hidden flank vents, such as this lava flow shown on screen, which originated in 1978. Of course, caldera-forming eruptions or distant lava flows are not needed to make this volcano dangerous. During the 2000s, it produced two of the largest eruptions on the planet of the 21st century so far. One of these eruptions in 2019 created a 62,000-foot-tall ash plume and resulted in pyroclastic flows reaching 8 kilometers from the overall summit. A similarly large eruption occurred in 2000, both of which were rated on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 4. Thus, this volcano is consistently a headache for aircraft navigating the area as its frequent explosive eruptions make it impossible to fly these craft due to the threat of ash damaging their engines. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, if you wish to support this channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon.